When Bank of Japan hiked its interest rate at the end of July, the global stock market went into turbulence. And we will discuss what is a currency carry trade, and especially why the yen currency carry trade has caused this global volatility over the past few weeks. And importantly, will this bull market resume back its uptrend again? My name is Con Hao. My work in this channel is to study behavior science and finance, discover correlation between different markets, and uncover potential opportunities. And before we discuss about today's subject, please do take some time to read into the disclaimer. Now let's first discover about what is a yen carry trade. And before that, let's also understand about the Japanese interest rate environment. At the beginning of 2016, for the first time in their history, their interest rate falls below 0%, which is at minus 0.1%. And this caused a lot of investors to think out of the box. What if I borrow money in Japanese yen, where I don't have to pay interest? I'm going to use this money, convert it to buy into other currency, say, for example, in the US dollars. And just by doing that, I'm earning interest in US dollars. And that's a very good deal. It's almost risk-free. And the more adventurous one, they use the US dollars to buy into equities. And we can see that since 2016, the market troughed, and from then the market went into a buying frenzy. Super bull. And it's not just to the US stock market. The many equity market also have the same behavior. And let's discover about the trading opportunity for the Nasdaq. And this uptrend line was drawn about a few months back. And my strategy was to buy on dips since the market is on a bull run. And I also said that, however, if it broke below this uptrend line, my strategy will have changed. And especially if it also come along with a fundamental shift. And exactly on the 31st of July, BOJ make a very strong stance that they're going to tame down the inflation and interest rate should be on the rise. And that's technical plus fundamental. And moving forward, instead of buying on dips, since there's a change in trend, my strategy is to sell into strength. And what I'm going to do here is I believe that the next few days, and based on this hammer and this slightly bullish candle, I believe the next few days the market will continue to move up, but that doesn't really that interest me that much. I will focus more on to sell into strength. And let's discover about what happened to Japanese yen. And we can see that since 2011, the Japanese yen has been falling. And when the currency falls, for travelers like myself or yourself, I think we all love to go to Japan, because it is true that the market there, it seems very affordable compared to what's back home. But we have to think in terms of the Japanese perspective. If the yen has fallen, whatever the import, it became more expensive. And I would say that since 2011 until today, it has never been an easy time for the Japanese. It means that the inflation is growing and they have to pay more for everything that they have, or especially everything that they import. And therefore, BOJ have, after more than a decade, they have started to hike interest rate on March this year and followed by July this year. But we can see that with this policy, new policy, that finally it seems to me that the yen is having some support, which is good for the Japanese market. With a stronger yen, and I hope that the inflation will be having a better control. And let's discuss about the longer term strategy for the US market. And earlier I did say that for the next few days it's moving up, and I'm taking an opportunity to sell into strength. But the long term, on that idea about perhaps the yen could go stronger, it also means that the US dollars could be weaker. And with a weaker US dollars, it also means that the inflation perhaps may turn around from 3%, may move up. And that's not good news. And that's, I believe, for the reason Jerome Powell has never given his commitment that he's going to cut interest rate in the next few meetings. I think he's very cautious. And I would say that he's very responsible. And that's number one, inflation for US is not actually out of the woods yet. But the second thing that I'm a bit more concerned is the growth, the economy of US. And we could see that the jobless number is on the climb. And before that, the jobless number is about 3%, but suddenly it just picked up. The May number is at 4, the June number is at 4.1, and the July jobless rate is at 4.3. And that also speaks of perhaps the US economy may be slowing. On that note of a potential weaker dollar that may bring forth inflation threat once again, and also a slower economy, I believe that the correction may be deeper this time around. The market are always telling us on their next move. Stay tuned for our coming tutorial. Remember to subscribe to my channel. Join us in our weekly case study and discussion. Click on my profile icon or description below to find out more. Feel free to leave me any comments below. I'd love to exchange ideas with you. Really happy that you stayed through this tutorial. You have many great trading weeks ahead.